Subhanallah, Harun Rashid rahmatullahi alayh, one of the great Abbasid Khalifs. If you don't know who he is, but just understand he was a great leader of the Muslim Ummah in the Banu Abbas. And he's noted for establishing Darul Hikmah and great Islamic seminaries, institutes and the likes. Anyways, what happened was is that he built this big yard, massive yard, and he embellished it with everything he could get his hands on, made a masterpiece, an absolute masterpiece of his time. So he gave everybody da'wah, like we do, isn't it? You build a house or and then you call everyone for da'wah and you say, look at mashallah, look at the wall, look at the marble. And under other people are saying, mashallah, like in Andalus Arnavion, and look what he's got. And then we go home, and this is the problem, I'll say this, right? You know when you have brothers that go to holidays abroad, when they come back, they're ghab, you don't see them. I thought he came back a month ago. Yeah, but he's been working 16 hours a day since he returned. Why? Because tane millina, what have you done? You've been sitting in England for 15 years. Where you've been sitting 15 years, what have you got? They go, okay, what have you got? Tu nakam insan yaar, tu flanaya dingya. That's what happens. So him, the same mindset 1400 years ago, 3000 years ago, has always been the same. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned, لِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ fitna, وَفِتْنَ أُمَّتِي al-mal. Mal, wealth will be a distraction. And it will be a fitna for my ummah. Anyway, Abu Lata'iyya rahmatullahi alayhi, what's he saying? He got caught to this banquet. He got caught to this banquet. Look at the Thailand, look at the pump. So they're looking at it and everyone's giving their ta'arif. But then what did he say? He said, عِشْ مَا بَدَى لَكَ سَالِمَا فِي ظِلِّ شَاهِكَةِ الْقُسُورِ. But he said it in Arabic poetry because he is a poet. Spit bars, right? You know what spitting bars is, right? So he spat bars in Arabic. He goes, عِشْ مَا بَدَى لَكَ سَالِمَا فِي ظِلِّ شَاهِكَةِ الْقُسُورِ يُسْعَى إِلَيْكَ مَشْتَهَيْتَ لَدَى الرَّوَاحِيَ وَالْبَكُورِ. So he said these first two jumlas, which translated means, by living these big, tall, lofty buildings, providing this great, great sire and this great shadow for you. Living comfortable, living peace, you will live in peace. Anytime you need something, everything, يُسْعَى إِلَيْكَ مَشْتَهَيْتَ, anything you desire, anything you want, at your beck and call will be bought for you. When you come, when you go, morning, noon and night, anything that your need will be met. And now he's, as they say, gassed. You know gassed, right? He was gassed. So then what happened was, he turned around and goes, فَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ تَقَعْقَعَتْ فِي ذِيقِ حَشْرَجَةِ الصُّدُورِ فَهُنَاكَ تَعْلَمُ مُوقِنَا مَا كُنْتَ إِلَّا فِي غُرُورِ. Oi, oi, oi. When he said this, when he was so gassed and he was happy, he goes, and then, now he wants to hear more. He said, but then a time will have to come and pass. A time will happen, it will come to you. You can live in a 1500 kanal place. You can live in a 1200 marala place. You can live in a 10 acre plot, a ranch, a palace, a kingdom. You can live in the skies, on the ground, on another planet. Wallahi, death will come to you exactly the same way as it came from the first person to the last. You can't escape it, my brother. You can't escape it, my sister. He said, a time will come, فَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ تَقَعْقَعَتْ. What will happen is that your soul will start making this knocking sound in the chest of your body. And it will come in the tightness of your chest, you will feel your soul being taken out. فَهُنَاكَ تَعْلَمُ مُوقِنَا. Put your makan to the side, put your wealth to the side, put your business to the side, put your children's degrees to the side. Now you will know when your soul is being taken. Oh, I was in a loss. I should have done more for my akhirah. At that time, he started crying. And you know, they say, yeah, Molvi, yaar, inaki na dawa dita karo, khush klokan. You know, because if you call a few, because they'll say, no, don't do that, you shouldn't do that, rather don't do that. Rather, but it's all hikmah. Baby. What does Maulana get out of telling you to become good in the akhirah? Maulana ko commission milte hai, bhai? Does he get any money from you? Do I get, let's just say, hypothetically, out of this gathering, 100 of you were to become the walis of your time. Does that help me? Bhai, does that help me? No, it doesn't. For akhirah, that's another story. In this world, nothing's happening. And now we want it either. Your benefit, my brother. And this is the thing ulama have always wanted. They tell you this. Not because they're telling you off or they dislike you. They have a dard, Allahu Akbar. Okay, I can see that if they just practiced upon deen, their lives could be potentially so much more better. There's that pain that keeps the ulama constantly advising our communities.